Today's lecture, I am going to explain the types of sentences and the functional classification of the sentences. There is classification of sentences based on different functions of a sentence. Such functions are like asking questions for information, giving instructions, expressing views, etc. Sentences are given different names according to their functions. Now in detail, types of sentences according to their functions, I would like to explain one by one. Number one, affirmative sentence that calls as a statement. It expresses a view or describes a state of affairs. For example, the sun sets in the west. Now the second one type, negative sentence. It expresses a view which is opposite to that of a statement. For example, students do not like study. Third one, imperative sentence that calls as an order or the request. It is used to issue commands. For example, open the door. In this way, according to the various types of sentences, which also classified according to their functions. Now, the first one, the various types of sentences according to the function. The first one type of sentence is WH questions. WH questions is an interrogative sentence. It is called so because it begins it with the question word which begins with WH word. For example, where are you going? Number two, why are you singing, etc. WH question are used to seek more information about something. For example, how is used to know the manner of the action, when examines time, while where investigates the location of the action. A WH question is formed by placing the WH word at the beginning of a sentence, which is followed by the auxiliary verb. For example, who could not write the paper? Why could not Rahul write the paper? Etc. Now I am going to explain yes no type questions. This type of question does not ask new information. On the contrary, it seeks to confirm if the statement of affairs described is true or false. The answer to these questions are usually in yes or no, and so they are called yes no questions. For example, Avi said, do you like dance? Babu said, no, I do not like. Second one example, Ajay, has Rahul come? Vijay said, yes, he has. Yes no questions are formed by moving the auxiliary verb to the beginning of the sentence. For example, Reena is getting ready. Is Reena getting ready? Etc. Now the third one type of the question according to the function, that is tag questions. Tag questions too are used to confirm information expressed by a statement. They are similarly in function to the yes-no questions. However, in them, we do not move the auxiliary to the front or the beginning of the sentence. On the contrary, the auxiliary is duplicated and put it at the end of the statement. Then we use a pronoun which presents the subject of the sentence. Thus, the auxiliary is used twice in the normal position and as a part of the tag question mark. For example, Lena is getting ready. The answer of this question is, Lena is getting ready, isn't she? Second one example, I cannot buy a car. The answer of this statement is, I cannot buy a car, can I? It should be noted that when the statement is positive, the tag question has a negative auxiliary. On the contrary, when the statement is negative, the auxiliary is positive. In other words, a positive statement has a negative tag and a negative statement has a positive tag. For example, Neeta is getting ready. This is a positive statement. The answer of this statement is, Neeta is getting ready, isn't she? This is a negative statement. Second one example, Neeta isn't getting ready. This is example of negative statement. The answer of this टैग क्वेश्चन इज नीता इजंट गेटिंग रेडी इज शी क्वेश्चन मार्क. नाउ द लास्ट वन पॉइंट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दैट इज नेगेटिव सेंटेंसेस. नेगेटिव सेंटेंसेस आर यूज टू एक्सप्रेस एन अपोजिट ओपिनियन टू दैट ऑफ एन अफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस. द नेगेटिव सेंटेंस इज फॉर्म बाय यूजिंग द वर्ड नॉट आफ्टर द ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब. फॉर एग्जाम्पल पूजा इज गेटिंग रेडी फॉर द पार्टी. द आंसर ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट इज पूजा इज नॉट रेडी फॉर द पार्टी. सेकेंड वन एग्जाम्पल चिल्ड्रन लाइक स्वीट्स. द आंसर ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट इज इन द नेगेटिव चिल्ड्रन डू नॉट लाइक स्वीट्स एट्सेट्रा. नाउ द लास्ट वन पॉइंट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंस दैट इज इम्परेटिव्स. इम्परेटिव सेंटेंसेस आर यूज टू इशू इंस्ट्रक्शंस विच द लिसनर मस्ट कैरी आउट. इन अदर वर्ड्स दे एक्सप्रेस ऑर्डर्स एंड कमांड्स. द ऑर्डर इज गिवन बाय द स्पीकर टू द लिसनर हु इज प्रेजेंट. द स्पीकर इज ऑलवेज द फर्स्ट पर्सन सिंग्युलर आय and the listener is always the second person you. These sentences are orders and so contain the auxiliaries signifying order. Such auxiliaries are like, must and should. In an imperative sentence both of these are dropped. This is not because they are not necessary but because they are clearly known for the context. For example you must go and close the door is an example. You must go and close the door. This is an example of affirmative sentence. The answer is go and close the door. This is an example of imperative sentence. Second one, go and close the door is an example of imperative sentence.